سواء كان هذا باللسان
whether this is upon one's tongue
أو بالحركات باليد
or even in terms of the symbols that people use in their hands.
فالمسلم لا يمكن أن يصنع شيء من هذا.
So Muslim cannot go on with either this meaning swearing upon the tongue or even with his fingers and his hands.
مهما كان هذا الأسباب.
Whatever the reason is, whatever the cause is, a Muslim does not do this.
قل أبالله وآياته ورسوله كنتم تستهزئون.
Allah says in the Quran that say to them that were you mocking, were you making mockery of Allah and His verses and the Messenger?
فما بالك بسب الرب.
And then how about insulting Allah like some people do?
وسب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And insulting the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وسب الدين.
And insulting the religion.
بل نهينا عن سب آلهة الكفار وحضور الكفار حتى لا يؤدي هذا إلى سب الرب سبحانه وتعالى.
Rather we have been it has been forbidden for us to insult the deities or the false gods of the disbelievers in front of them, so it doesn't lead them to insulting Allah.
ثم بعد هذا يكبر ويجلس.
And then after this, a person says Allahu Akbar and he sits up.
إذا ما استطاع أنه يضع الرجلين هكذا يعني لأنه غير معتاد كيف يصنع يتدرب قبل الصلاة قبل الدخول في الصلاة يتدرب على الجلوس في الصلاة.
So as you can see from the brother,
يجلس يجلس على هذا.
His toes are down facing the Qibla, even the toes themselves. If the brother isn't able to do this because he's not used to it, then before he prays, he needs to train himself to do this.
يعني تدرب على هذه الجلسة. يجلس هكذا ويسجد.
So for example, train yourself like this. Sit like this with your feet propped up.
نعم.
And then going to sujood.
ثم يجلس هكذا.
So his toes become like this.
ويسجد مرة أخرى حتى يعتاد على أن يضع باطن أصابع الرجلين على الأرض متجه بالأصابع للقبلة.
Up until a person is able to place the bottom of his toes down firmly on the ground facing the Qibla.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا يجلس بعد السجود يجلس.
So meaning the person isn't on his toes like this, rather the toes are facing the Qibla.
هذه الجلسة
like this.
في كل جلسات الصلاة ينصب اليمنى ويجعل باطن أصابع اليمنى على الأرض ويتجه بالأصابع للقبلة ويفترش اليسرى.
So this is the sitting that is done in all of the prayers that a person sits on his left foot and props up his right foot and the toes of his right foot are facing the Qibla, firmly planted on the ground facing the Qibla.
نعم. هذا في كل جلسات الصلاة.
And this is in all of the sittings of the prayer.
بين السجدتين.
Between the two prostrations.
وفي التشهد الأول.
In the first tashahud, the first sitting.
أما في التشهد الأخير إذا كانت الصلاة ثلاثية كالمغرب أو رباعية كالعشاء.
As for if there is a second sitting of the tashahud, i.e. if the prayer is 3 rak'at or 4 rak'at and there's a second sitting,
يتورق.
Then a person forms what they call a tawarruq.
يصح. بأن يضع يدخل اليسرى من أسفل ساق اليمنى.
So the meaning of tawarruq is
ينصب اليمنى.
That he props up his right foot.
ويجعل اليسرى تحت ساق اليمنى.
And he makes his left foot come under the shin of his right foot.
نعم.
It's easier to see than to describe.
ماذا يقول بين السجدتين؟
So what should a person say between his two prostrations?
سبحان الله.
The rest of you don't know.
ماذا يقول؟
What should a person say when he sits up between the two prostrations, the two sujood? He
said,
you say رب اغفرني. So you say رب اغفرني.
نعم يقول رب اغفر لي.
He says رب اغفر لي.
مرة واحدة وجوبا.
He has to say it once as an obligation.
ويصح أن يزيد استحبابا رب اغفر لي رب اغفر لي أي الثالثة وهكذا.
And it's permissible for a person or recommended for a person to increase over one time, two or three times saying رب اغفر لي رب اغفر لي رب اغفر لي and so on.
هل يصح أن يقول رب اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمسلمين والمسلمات مثلا؟
Is it correct for a person to say like this, you know, increase رب اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين؟
لا.
No, it's not permissible.
هل يصح أن يقول ربنا ولك الحمد والشكر
Is it permissible when you stand up from the ruku' that you say, رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ وَالشُّكْرُ?
لا.
No.
لأن هذه الصلاة توقفية.
Because the prayer, it is a توقفية, meaning the prayer can only be done in the way which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. So he did, and we stay away from that which he did not do. We can't invent things and add to things how we want.
ثم يسجد السجدة الثانية.
And then after sitting goes back into the second prostration.
ثم يقوم إلى الثانية.
And then he stands up to his for the second rak'ah, for the second unit.
يصنع في الركعة الثانية ما صنع في الركعة الأولى.
And he does the same actions in the second unit of prayer like he did in the first unit of prayer.
إلا أن الركعة الثانية ليس فيها تكبيرة إحرام.
Except in the second unit of prayer there is not تكبيرة الإحرام, the initial الله أكبر.
فيها تكبيرة انتقال بين السجدة الثانية والركعة الثانية.
But the Allahu Akbar that he says when he's getting up from the prostration is called takbiratul intiqal, meaning the takbir for moving from one position to another position.
فَإِذَا انْتَهَى مِنَ الثَّانِيَ جَلَسَ لِلتَّشَهُّدِ.
So then if he has finished from his second rak'ah, meaning his sujood, then he sits for التَّشَهُّد, the sitting.
نعم. يَضَعْ بَاطِنَ الْكَفَّيْنِ عَلَى أَطْرَافَ الْفَخِذَيْنِ.
So he places the palms of his hands towards the edge of his thighs.
نعم. ويشير بالمسبحة والسبابة.
And he points with his index finger.
يحرك يدعو بها.
And he moves it while supplicating, while making dua.
طيب. ثم بعد هذا إذا انتهى من التشهد يصلي الصلاة الإبراهيمية على النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And then if he has, once he has finished saying the تشهد, then he sends salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as is in what they call al-Ibrahimiyya. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala al-Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim.
Thumma yasta'in billahi min arba'.
And then he seeks refuge in Allah from four things.
Thumma ba'da hadha yad'u bima warad wal awla, yad'u bima ahab wal awla, yad'u bima warad an Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
And then after seeking refuge from these four things, then he can make dua for whatever he wants. Now it is better to make dua with the supplications that have been narrated.
مواطن الدعاء في الصلاة في موضعين.
So therefore, the positions or the places for supplications whilst in the prayer are two.
في السجود.
In the prostration, the sujood.
وفي التشهد قبل التسليم.
And then when you're sitting just before you say the taslim.
ثم يسلم عن يمينه ثم عن يساره.
And then the person he says assalamu alaykum rahmatullah to his right and his left.
الأخطاء في التسليم.
Okay, the errors whilst making taslim.
تحريك الرأس هكذا قبل التسليم.
Moving the head up and down like this before you make taslim.
أو تحريك اليدين أو الضرب على الفخذين.
Or moving your hands or hitting your thighs with your hands.
أو عند اليمين يحرك اليمنى وعند اليسار يحرك اليسار.
Or like some people do when they make the seam towards right, they move the right hand. And when they make the seam towards left, they move the left hand.
أو ينحرف عن القبلة بمنكبين. يعني يقول السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وكذا.
Or for example, a person turns away or deviates away from the qibla with his shoulders. So when he's making the first taslim, he moves all his body and his shoulders.
نعم. أو عندما يسلم اليمنى براسه هكذا ثم يسلم اليسرى.
Or when a person makes the taslim, goes to the right hand, when he brings it back to the center, he goes down, then he does left.
نعم. بهذا عندما يفرغ وينتهي من الصلاة, هذه إذا كانت الصلاة ثنائية كالفجر.
So this, a person would complete the prayer if the prayer is only two units of prayer, like the Fajr prayer.
فإن كانت الصلاة ثلاثية أو رباعية.
And if the prayer is three units or four units.
بعد أن يفرغ وينتهي من التشهد.
After
التشهد الأول.
After a person has finished from his first tashahud, the first sitting.
يستحب له أن يقول الصلاة الإبراهيمية.
It is recommended for him to say the Salah Ibrahimi and salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
ثم يكبر ويقوم إلى الثالثة.
And then he says Allahu Akbar and he gets up for the third unit. So
مع رفع اليدين عندما يقوم.
Just to repeat that if a person is praying a prayer which is three units or four units, like the Maghrib prayer or the Isha prayer, after the first tashahud, whilst he's sitting, it's recommended for him to say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad and send salutations upon the Prophet. And then he stands up saying Allahu Akbar for the third unit of prayer.
عندما يقوم يرفع اليدين.
And when he stands up, then he raises his hand. And then he says, Allahu Akbar, whilst raising his hands. And then he prays the third unit of prayer and the fourth unit of prayer. And then he sits down for the last sitting of tashahud, and then he makes his taslim. So in the final tashahud now, he says the salutations and the blessings upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After the tashahud,
واستعذ بالله من أربع,
and after seeking refuge, and then he seeks refuge from Allah in four matters.
وادعو بما ورد,
and then he can supplicate with any supplication, but it's best to do that which has been narrated.
ثم يسلم,
and then he makes a taslim.
والحمد لله رب العالمين. والحمد لله. نريد يعني الآن نطبق الآن السجود.
So now we want every single one of you facing the Qibla to make a sujood so we can check if there's any errors.
بعد المغرب هم يجتمعون فيما بينهم.
Okay, so now all of you sit together in your groups.
ويطبقوا.
And pray the prayer, like pray for one unit and let others look at this unit and see if it's correct or not.
وبعد المغرب إن شاء الله نطبق صفة الوضوء والتيمم والاغتسال إن شاء الله.
And after the Maghrib prayer, we're going to go through the description of the wudu, and the description of the tayammum, and the description of the ghusl.
Allahu
a'lam. And Allah knows best.